My son, second son, got through his O-level exam. Sat last December and got through the exam. February, he got his results. Oh, just a month or 2 months ago, he got his results. I asked him, what do you need? He said, get me the latest, the most modern Sony smartphone. I said, sure. So we bought the phone. What happened? And he inserted his SIM to it. It said that SIM not inserted right. Pressed a couple of times, it didn't come out. So the excitement, the joy what he had was just taken away within a couple of seconds. Immediately, we took it to the vendor. And that person put a pin and then started taking it out. And he put the blame and said, did you all meddle around with the phone? As a result, it's not coming out now. I said, no, we tried a couple of times, it didn't come. So inside's broken, just within an hour or so. So I said, what are you going to do? It's quite an expensive phone. And said that we will send it to the workshop, and within 2 days' time, we will get it rectified. I said, okay. I handed over the phone around about 8 o'clock in the night because the shop was open. Now, here we are, you give a phone to somebody, it's okay. There's a warranty period, they will rectify and give. But I had a concern. What are the concerns, Iran? The SIM was inside. If somebody starts using it, I become responsible for the bill. So I called that service provider call center, and I explained this. This is what exactly happened. I purchased a phone to my son, and then SIM was inserted. It didn't work. We started taking it out, and it never happened. So we went and handed it over to the vendor, and he agreed to rectify it and give. But only thing what he said was it might take about at least 2 days. So I'm calling here to cancel this number. You have to give that in writing. Where? You must visit one of our centers, and then you've got to do it. So then I said, I'm living here. What is my closest center? They said their closest center is at such and such place. But now the time is 10 past 8, they're closed. Then I said, how can then you cancel this? Until tomorrow morning, nothing can be done. So if this person, to whoever I have handed over, unknown guy, but they are representative of that company, but they have access towards this SIM, and if they start using it, who become responsible? You. Exactly the story I'm telling you what happened. I said, come on, this won't do. Now, in case if a person loses his mobile phone in the midnight, what do you do? No, then when he calls and says that he had misplaced the phone, we disconnect it. So, come on, now I told a similar story. No, no, but you said a different story. So therefore we can't, believe me. Then I said, okay, so had I told you the phone had misplaced, what would have you done? No letter needed, nothing, we can disconnect. Would you believe this? Would you believe this is happening in this country? Right. Then I said, okay, now I am telling you I misplaced the phone. No, no, you told the truth before, no, so therefore now nothing can be done. Then I said, okay, had I lied to you, then I had the solution. Now, since I was honest and told you the truth, I'm not going to get the solution. Yes. So until tomorrow morning, I don't have a solution. No, sir, you said no, sir, that okay, this is what exactly happened. Had you told me that okay, you had misplaced the phone, we should have done something. But it's a different story. Okay, then I said, now I'm going to disconnect this line and then I'm going to call you. Call another line. Somebody else will answer. Then that person I'm going to tell that it had got misplaced. Then he will do the needful. You try your luck and see, sir. Believe me, this is happening in this country. So what did I do? I straight away got hold of a senior of that particular organization, and I said, is it the case? He said, these guys are talking nonsense. What do you want me to do, Dhammika? I said, this is it. So aren't you coming across instances of this sort in this country when it comes to service encounters? The whole problem today, not having a great service culture, is something that can be done with common sense is not being done. Something that can be done with common sense is not being done. This is the whole problem. You need not go to a school to learn about or to do a degree to learn about service. I told you. From the time we are born to this world until we die, we need it. It's a day-to-day activity. We need this service. And there are things that can be done with common sense. Common sense. What did all the religious leaders, what did they tell us? Be good, do good, serve the mankind the best manner you could. And this is a learning what we got from our religions. Very basic, simple thing. But the whole problem is today it's not being practiced. Why? Common sense had become so uncommon. Using common sense, it had become so uncommon. Now, this never happened yesterday. 2,600 years ago, there was a philosopher in the world called Confucius. He said a wonderful statement like this. The existence of the world, to a greater extent, will depend on the application of common sense. However, right throughout the existence of the world, using common sense will be the most uncommon thing to be found. So this never happened yesterday. Even so many years ago, this had been the case. Something that you can do with common sense is so uncommon. Confucius had said that. That's why people like us are busy. Because something that can be done with common sense is so uncommon. Therefore, now there's a commercial name tagged to this particular subject. What we learn from our religion, now the subject matter is customer service. Please come and train us staff on customer service. So we are busy.